हेलो
अनुराग जी, प्लीज
या
कैरी ऑन विथ योर
ओके सी आई थिंक द टाइम इज वेरी लेस 5 o'clock इट हैज टू रैप अप
नो अनुराग जी, इट्स ओके, प्लीज
ओके
इट्स
हेलो
फाइन, वी कैन एक्सटेंड अप टू 5 to 10 minutes, प्लीज स्पीक.
हेलो
वी कैन
हेलो
एक्सप्लोर आर्टिकल सर, प्लीज गो अहेड,
या
इट्स
सी
ओके, 5 minutes.
देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ वॉइस Yeah, there is a lot of voice echo. Anyhow, like if you can hear me properly, I'll just try to say, see, some new things which I want to mention. Like, first of all, it's a very nice thing to know that in these tough times, all these women entrepreneurs are there. One very important thing which I want to mention, try to look for exports. Okay, it may be sounding a little bit strange to you, but I am really laying a lot of focus on exports. There is a new concept called e-residency, which has come up in two countries in Europe. One is Lithuania and one is Estonia. Suppose Green Leaf Solutions is there, or any of the participants today, they want to do exports in the European markets without flying down to Europe. The two governments in Europe, they have come out with an e-residency program. This is something very important. Sitting in India, you can tap entirely 28 countries across Europe, whatever your product is there. How to apply for that e-residency program? What are the benefits? That we can cover maybe in a separate webinar. So, e-residency for approaching the European markets. Second thing is, there is a startup entrepreneurship visa which is coming up in Canada, Australia. I'm trying to give you something very new. Okay, suppose some of you have some good ideas or you are already a successful entrepreneurs. There are certain countries, for example, the Canadian government, they are simply asking you to give an online idea, or if you are already running a successful enterprise in India, you have to submit an online idea. And if they feel that this particular idea can create some employment in Canada, in Denmark, then they will invite you to come over there. They will even provide you funding support. They will provide you IPR protection. All these kind of benefits are there. And if I have to look at the ease of doing business, those countries are really, really practical in terms of ease of doing business. There are very few people who are aware of the startup visa. There is no investment which is required, only your idea or your existing business unit in India. Second thing about the European markets. European market, there are around 25 or 26 countries. Sitting in India, you can open an office in these countries. You can open a bank account without going there. It's a really very, very good opportunity. Maybe we can cover it separately. Third part, which I want to say, whatever your output is there, your product or services, try to look for government platforms like e-Mahila Heart is there. It is nice to know that Kao Mart is there. It's a new thing which has come out. GeM Portal is there. e-Mahila Heart is there, NSIC, MSME Mart is there. All these platforms, these are government Amazon, these are government Flipkart. You can list your products. Your pricing will be much better as compared to Amazon because the government is not asking for any commission or any listing charges from you. And you can approach the global market. You have to mention in your letterhead, you can mention in your visiting card that you have listed your products on NSIC, MSME Mart, on the GeM portal. The second part is, if you approach a banker for your financial loans, the moment the banker sees in your project report that you are having an e-residency of Europe, you are supplying to government platforms, you have been selected under the Canadian startup visa. These things make a very, very positive impression. Another point which I want to mention, see, today, first of all, the most important part is how to identify a product. If you go to a bank, you are saying, I am doing stationery manufacturing, I am doing notebook manufacturing. There are so many people who are doing it. You may be a very ethical entrepreneur. Many of the entrepreneurs don't do that. They may not be having invoicing, they may not be having GST and all that. Another important thing which I want to say, every country across the globe are having a startup. Startup Canada, Startup Israel. Go to those websites. All those countries have listed successful projects on their website. You can look on Startup Israel, Startup Canada. What are the successful ventures which are happening there? Simply, you have to start doing those products in India. when you prepare your project report that you are bringing a technology of notebook manufacturing, which is happening very successfully in Sweden, the banker will feel very confident. See, I myself have worked in the World Bank. I had done an international career. Try to think from the banker's perspective. The banker has been instructed by the government not to ask for collateral. And you are a person who is saying, I don't have any land, I don't have an FDR, I don't have any assets, I am a new entrepreneur. In that situation, which product you are taking up, what are the kind of credentials of that idea, that is what makes the project report stand out. Attend that another important, so this like idea identification. One more important thing is, in the beginning of the session, you were saying that you are looking for incubators, expanding into another countries, like another parts of India. I am already like the in charge for an incubator at Delhi University. If the COCOW association is interested, we can have an MOU with you. There is no rental charges. Huge, huge space is there. You can simply start your incubator there. The good part is that since it is in Delhi, all the central government ministries, all various global organizations like the World Bank, UNDP, they have a lot of financing for women entrepreneurs, but to do follow up with them. So if you require a space under Delhi University, Government of India, we can provide you free incubator space. Only you can set up your, maybe you can make up some investment to bring some machinery. That is another like opportunity which I want to tell. Apart from that, there are many things. Sometimes what happens, you apply for a loan, but the bank doesn't approve it, or they say that reason is there, this reason is there. One scheme called Prime Minister Employment Generation Program is there. I have heard about Mudra. I have heard about Credit Guarantee Scheme. They really are good to know, but practically what happens at a bank, like Shri Devi is there on this call. I had an interaction with her. Lot of issues comes up. So I will strongly suggest to all the participants, your first preference should be for the PMEGP scheme. PMEGP scheme is an online scheme. You are not dependent on anyone. You don't need to go to any bank. You don't need to visit any consultant. Prime Minister Employment Generation Program, only one or two pages of online form is there. Only requirement is a project report and an Aadhaar card. The amount of funding which is given is 25 lakh. It can be scaled up to 1 crore. Now, second part is, suppose you say I have a requirement for 2 crores. My suggestion is start with the PMEGP scheme. Take 10 lakhs, take 30 lakh, take 40 lakh, then go for a top up. The good part is once you approach a consortium bank, you can say very confidently that already my project has been selected and funded for 10 lakh or for 50 lakh. Now I am asking for a top up. If you go to a bank, no, I want 2 crore straight away, the bank are generally hesitant. So if you say under the PMEGP scheme, central government scheme, already I have got 10 lakh, 20 lakh, 30 lakh, 40 lakh, then you can go for a top up. Another small thing, because the time is slow, I'm just trying to give you some successful tips. Another thing is there, many times what happens, you need to be a little bit legally aware. What does legal awareness means? Shri Devi is there. There's another woman entrepreneur in India, in Delhi. She is a faculty at Delhi University. Her husband is into textile exports to European markets. Central Bank of India, Delhi branch is there. They are facing a lot of funding issues. Simply, you have to file an RTI application. When you are approaching central banks, Canara Bank, Syndicate Bank, Bank of Baroda, whichever branch is there, people are not aware. Simply put up, there is a public grievance portal is there, which is a central government scheme. Log a complaint there, or I will use a much more softer word, lodge a grievance there that you have gone to State Bank, highly motivated by the Prime Minister's speech, highly motivated by the Chief Minister's speech, but you are getting funding issues. Simply register your grievance under the Ministry of Finance or under the Ministry of MSME that you had gone to an X bank, there you have applied for a loan under the Credit Guarantee Scheme, which is completely funded by the central government. There is no collateral required. Still, the bank is not giving me the funding. I am having 6 years of relationship. I am having so many confirmed orders are there. There are balance sheet. Those things really work. Then what happens? The Ministry of MSME marks it to Secretary, Department of Financial Services, under which all these banks come. under this particular process, that particular grievance goes to Central Bank of India or to the State Bank of India, and they have to file a closure report within 30 days that what action has been taken. An ex-entrepreneur from Hyderabad has gone to State Bank of India, why she has not been given funded. When a bank branch manager gets to know that the entrepreneur is little bit aware, he or she knows that there is a public grievance commission, she knows how to file an RTA application, it definitely makes a change. Generally, in my experience, I've seen people are not aware of these redressal mechanisms. There is an ombudsperson in the RBI. So many, see, all government schemes are good. The biggest issue in India is the implementation. Very good scheme or how to apply in those schemes. One another important thing which I want to tell all these entrepreneurs, they must be having accounting, GST, taxation, how to apply for a government scheme. At the Delhi University incubator, which I am looking after, see all these pain points. I was with the Ministry of Skill Development as a senior advisor. I realized that practically if an entrepreneur gets into administrative work, when he or she will do her business. So at the Delhi University, we are providing you complete back office support. Suppose you have to do accounting, we will do it for you. You have to do a GST registration, you have to do exports, you don't know anything about shipping, you don't know anything about air cargo. Everything is done at the incubator. It is at a social pricing. We have two kind of pricing. It can be a slab rate, like it can be a monthly fee, it can be something transaction based. This incubator is managed by students of Delhi University. Now, this is something very nice to tell you. The students who are doing their MCOM, some of them are doing their chartered accountancy, some are doing their BCOM, they are looking for internship. So it's a win-win model. We are providing you transaction service. Those students are getting an internship experience. And the entire operation is supervised by me, or there are some other members which are there. So you don't need to go to any consultant. In today's presentation, you got to know about Stand Up India scheme, but how to fill up the form. Some of you may be quite highly literate, but some of you are may not be that literate about how to fill up the form or how to prepare a project report. Then you may have to go to some consultant. There may be some kind of a financial issue. Here at the incubator, and most of the services are free, or we can provide you complete end-to-end solutioning for your entire business needs. So these are few things which I wanted to tell. If you have any questions, you can just let me know. Yeah.
Anurag sir, I have a question.
Yeah.
Devi ji shared about getting her loan converted to a collateral.
Hello.
Hello. Can you hear me, sir?
Hello.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, actually the voice was getting echoed. Yeah, tell me. Yeah.
So Shridevi ji shared with us that she got her loan converted into a collateral free loan under Stand Up India scheme with your support. But her organization, correct, her enterprise was already 3 years old at that time. So and the Stand Up India scheme is for greenfield enterprise, as we understand. Then sir, how was
okay the,
yeah, so hello.
Hello.
Sir Anurag sir.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me? Yes,
sir. See, actually the voice is echoing. Anyhow, like, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello. Yeah, see, the credit guarantee scheme. So under that particular, the Stand Up India loan got closed out and we can apply fresh under the credit guarantee scheme. That option is there. So credit guarantee scheme is a collateral free scheme. You are not supposed to give any collaterals to the bank. The same applies for Stand Up India scheme also. The issue which she faced was the bank was insisting for collaterals, which should not be the case. Hello. That is what I told her, that please go to the bank.
Enterprise was already 3 years old. So the as we understand, Stand Up India loan scheme is not applicable for an old organization. It is only applicable for greenfield enterprise. So that is the query, sir.
See, they are considering both the categories, the existing ones and the new ones also, yes, under the Stand Up India scheme.
Exactly.
They are considering both the, if you go to the Stand Up India, they are considering both the scenarios. If you are an existing entrepreneur or a new entrepreneur. See, my humble, my strong suggestion is there, if any of the participants, whether existing or new woman entrepreneur, for you, there is a Stand Up India scheme, which is a collateral free scheme. And there is a PMEGP scheme and there is a credit guarantee scheme. Try to approach the banks are themselves not aware. There are many situations where I have told the entrepreneur, I have written the mails on behalf of them to the bank. This is a credit guarantee trust scheme, which is funded by the MSME. You are not having any risk exposure. Only you need to go through the project report. If the entrepreneur is already existing, then it's good. It is adding to her credentials because she is able to produce her past credentials. But you cannot insist that you have to have some balance sheet. The future projections, that is what is required. So credit guarantee scheme, 2 crore rupees, Stand Up India scheme is there, PMEGP scheme is there. All these are collateral free.
Sir, Anurag sir, there are two questions which are contradictory.
Yeah.
In the eligibility part, the borrower should not be a defaulter, they say it.
Okay.
If it is a very new venture, how can the borrower be a defaulter? First thing. Second thing is, if this scheme is covered under CGTMSE scheme.
Hello.
Yes, sir. If the scheme is covered under CGTMSE, it is mentioned in the site that this is applicable for both new as well as existing firms. That's
correct.
Why you have sent me a mail on behalf of me to the banker, and wherein the banker has agreed for that.
See, these are many, like Nidhi ji, I'm just addressing to you, like in Gujarat also, there is a woman entrepreneur. She also told me that whenever she went to the branch, the Gujarat, one of the branch manager was asking for a collateral. I simply asked her if she can make me talk to the branch manager. I told him that again, this is a credit guarantee scheme. There is no collateral which is required. See, today, what is the situation? If you are an informed entrepreneur, it makes a huge difference. I'm not complaining about anyone, but generally the people in the bank, they are not aware, or you have to tell them, you have to help yourself. What Shri Devi also mentioned, or maybe one of the, you have to help yourself. We are not sitting in US, we are not sitting in Canada, we are not sitting in a European market. Here you have to help yourself. That is the reason I'm telling you for e-residency program. This e-residency program from the European Union, it's a very good program. Don't think yourself as just a local Indian entrepreneur. Think global. And it is not something I'm talking out of the sky. It is very much doable. We can do some sessions on that.
Definitely.
So you can really,
sir.
Can benefit by selling your product and service to the European markets. And there's a huge demand for that. You don't have to fly down there. You don't have to open a company there. Everything is digital. The European markets are completely getting they are becoming paperless. They want to encourage investment. So they have started a digital residency program. After this session, if you Google e-residency Estonia, you can look at that, the benefits which you can get. So I'm just giving you certain examples. Then one more thing, there are some defaults. Like there are some entrepreneurs whose payments get blocked. You have sold some products, the money doesn't come, or there's a check bouncing which happens. Now, the first option is, you will write emails, the person doesn't respond. I'm talking from practical experience.
Yes, sir.
So what somebody will tell you, file a legal case. My strong suggestion is legal option should be the last. Legal option should be the last in the pyramid. There is an MSME Samadhan scheme from the Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. First of all, try to use that scheme. Then there is a Lok Adalat which is there. Again, going to a court, especially in the Indian context, it's very, very time consuming process. The person who has defaulted, that person ultimately ends up benefiting. Don't expect you go to the court and the next day the order comes in. You file a petition, then there will be a 4 weeks time given to the opposite party. Many times the opposite party will not receive the notice. There are many people who are not aware of basic legal procedures.
Yes,
so MSME Samadhan scheme is there. You can write to certain industry bodies, because every packaging, spices, herbal product, for every entrepreneur, there is an association which is there. You can write to MSME. There is a Champions portal. Again, I don't know how many participants are aware of the Champions portal, which has been started by the MSME. Everyone should register their product, register their company. Another important thing, suppose you want to start an NGO. Today, social entrepreneurship is very much in demand. everybody is thinking, let me become some, let me do something for the society and let me make a earning for myself. If you have to start your business, only form of company is sole proprietor. Don't go for public limited company, private, if you have, good, but don't go into hassles of forming a public limited company. Many few people don't tell these things. Start with a sole proprietor, get yourself Udyog Aadhaar registration, which you can do from your own mobile. Suppose you want to move a little bit further, convert your sole proprietor into one person
company,
OPC, one person, full stop. After that, you don't need to worry. You can sell your products to US, you can sell your products to Middle East. Suppose you want to start a NGO, register your company as a Section 8 company. Section 8 is a not-for-profit company. Don't go for trust, don't go for society, don't go for cooperative. They are all meant for consultants. I have no issues with anyone. Simply go for Section 8 company. Now again, if you face any issues in the registration process, at the Delhi University, we are providing free services to entrepreneurs. Free services means it's an incubator set up by the government. We are providing you all kind of entrepreneurship support services. Last thing which I want to say, you must have heard of G Capital, you must have heard of Bank of America, you must have heard of outsourcing shared services center in Hyderabad, you must have heard of shared services center in Chennai. This is the first ever social enterprise shared services center which has been set up at Delhi University to provide end-to-end services to entrepreneurs. Whether it is your company registration, whether it is making a shipment to international markets, whether it is recovering your default payments, whether it is applying to a bank, whether it is applying to the World Bank. How many people today are aware that World Bank also provides women entrepreneurship loans of 10 lakh to 15 lakhs to 5 lakh rupees? Those organizations are very transparent. And how many of you are supplying your products and services to United Nations? During the COVID, I told to Madam this Shri Devi also, try to supply your products to world aid bodies. International Red Cross, United Nations has a huge procurement. They have a huge procurement. It is very transparent. Anybody who is sitting on this call, they can supply stationery, cloths, umbrella, any kind of services to United Nations. United Nations has a global procurement. Like for Afghanistan, they are looking for sourcing from India because India is quite near to Afghanistan relief operations. But hardly any people know about. They are looking for domestic market, and then sometimes so many issues are there. So international relief agencies, international aid agencies, they have all procurement departments. So these are something maybe we can cover in your future sessions. And yes, I sir, believe face-to-face, and face-to-face sessions are much better. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Definitely, sir. We'll use your...
so much.
So, thank you very much.
Wonderful session.
Yes, sir.
It is such a knowledge powerhouse.
Powerhouse. That's what I told you. That's what I told you, ma'am. It's a powerhouse.
Absolutely amazing. We need to have
an exclusive
session with Mr. Anurag Mittal.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Thanks to be part of it. Yeah.
Thank you so much.